Racing to the 2023 Kentucky Derby, and this time let's get an update for Sunday, March 5th. Separation Saturday is over. We did have a shocker in the Gotham at 23-1, a favorite one at Gulfstream. Forte, the two-year-old champion, returned, and Out West, Practical Move, cemented his status as the leading contender Out West. Let's take a look at all four races on the Kentucky Derby Trail from Super Saturday. Big day of racing, and let's go right to the big dog at Gulfstream Park, the Fountain of Youth. Big crowd on hand, perfect weather, overcast skies, and low 80s temperatures. And Forte looked good in the paddock, was bet down to 1-2 on the board. And Forte, let's pick him up here from fourth place. He made an inside to outside move, went to the lead, and Forte powered off to the big victory. Of course, he's trained by Todd Pletcher, and the sire is Violence, $100,000 bargain buy at the Keeneland September sale. Forte now picks up another big victory on his resume. He had three grade one wins as a two-year-old. He won the Breeders' Cup Juvenile, and now he adds the Fountain of Youth. The buyer speed figure comes back in 98, and it looks like the Florida Derby is going to be his final prep before the Kentucky Derby. Forte, definitely the Kentucky Derby leaderboard favorite at this point. Now you go out west. We go to the San Felipe. The big talk coming into this race was Practical Move. You have Hijazi, maiden winner the last time out. Go Rocket Ride was surprisingly bet down to the favorite off one maiden race. Let's pick it up on the turn. Practical Move, saving ground on the inside, cuts a corner, takes the lead, and powers off to victory. Hijazi fades off the screen. Go Rocket Ride comes back up for second. So Practical Move, a big speed figure in the Lausale Futurity, picks up the win here in the San Felipe. And early indications they're going to run one more time, most likely the Santa Anita Derby, before they move to Churchill Downs. Practical Move, a son of Practical Joke, and trained by Tim Yakteen. Now we go to the Big Apple. It was in New York. Sloppy track, a big field, and there was a couple of scratches, Fort Warren scratch, but still a big field in this race. Out of the gate, it was Carmel Road, leading a fast pace, was joined on the turn by the favorite in the race, Iron Clother, but out of the pack from last to first, Raise Cain. He picked up the win 23-1. Ben Colebrook, the trainer, and a big day for the Sire Violence. He not only had Forte, the Fountain of Youth winner, he has the sire of this one. Raise Cain now with 50 points on the Kentucky Derby Trail. Most likely going to run in the wood or the bluegrass, according to trainer Ben Colebrook. He's nominated to both, so we'll see where Raise Cain goes next, but he definitely will be in that starting gate. And now we go to Kentucky. It was John Battaglia. Of course, their big final prep is the Jeff Ruby Stakes, a synthetic surface. Antonio Sano, the trainer of Gunnavera, could have another Gunnavera on his hands here. Tammy Bobo, who had simplification last year in the Derby, now has got this one, Congruent. By Tappet, stride it out, let's pick it up, man. This was a nice win. Scramble on the turn, Bromley made a move, Moon Landing flattened out, and there it was, Congruent rolling to victory for the big gray son of Tappet. He'll be popular with the fans. They always like to bet the grays in the Derby. And looks like Congruent, you know, with the points, he still needs some more points, but he's on the leaderboard and he's moving in the right direction. He may just come right back for the Jeff Ruby Stakes. Let's take a look at that leaderboard. A shuffle at the top, and Forte is back to the leaderboard. He has got 90 points. He's in the gate. Practical Move, Santa Anita Derby next, most likely for him. Confidence Game, he is in the gate, most likely the Arkansas Derby, for, of course, he won the Rebel Stakes. Then you go to Angel of Empire. He is going to either go to the Rebel or the Bluegrass, or the Arkansas Derby are the bluegrass. Then you got Ray's Cain with 54 points. Rocket can clearly in the gate if they want. Of course, he finished second to Forte. We'll see if he comes back for the bluegrass or the Florida Derby. Red Route 1, the closer for Steve Asmussen. He's got 33. And then Instant Coffee pointing for the Louisiana Derby sits there with 32. And Congruent on the board with 20 points. Now, the Devona Dale, the big favorite in this race, was Red Carpet Ready, had won the Forward Gale. She had won her debut by 10 lengths. And in this race, she led into the turn. It was Red Carpet Ready, but a 45-1 shot was breathing down her neck. Darth Vader coming in from Tampa. And she was the invader here, picked up the win, powered off to victory. A long shot comes rolling up for second, trade by Chad Brown. So big boxcar payoffs in this race. Darth Vader now could be on her way to the Kentucky Oaks, picks up the points, and looks like they may be thinking Ashland Stakes or stay there at Gulfstream for the Gulfstream Park Oaks for her final start. Big win for Darth Vader. Tampa Bay Derby is going to be the focus this week. We're going to have some previews, and it looks like right now we've got Tappet Trice, Prairie Hawk, Roveland, Classic Car Wash. I'd say about an 8 or 9 horse field going to be expected, but should be a contentious Tampa Bay Derby as we close out the Tampa Bay Road to the Kentucky Derby. Now, the Louisiana Derby shaping up with an 8, 9, 10 horse field. You're going to have Tappet's Conquest, Instant Coffee, Dennington, Litigate, King's Barn possibly for Todd Pletcher, and possibly a few others pointing for that race. So the Louisiana Derby, definitely one to watch here. That'll be their final prep. We'll take a look as we're getting now to the middle of March, and that schedule looks like this. You've got Tampa Bay Derby, then we go the UAE Derby, Louisiana Derby, and Jeff Ruby Stakes, Sunland Stakes on Sunday, March 26th, and then April 1st, you've got the Florida Derby and the Arkansas Derby, and then the final week of preps is the Wood, the Santa Anita, and the Bluegrass, all on April 8th. Now, in the gate so far, we've got Confidence Game, Angel of Empire, Ray's Cain, Forte, Practical Move, Red Route 1, and you've also got Rocket Can, most likely guaranteed a starting berth in the gate. But right now, Forte, the most likely favorite for Kentucky Derby, 149. And a big day of racing. Now remember, if you like Kentucky Derby news and Triple Crown news, every week I write a newsletter from January and through the Belmont Stakes. We take a look at the race recaps. We preview some of the up-and-coming maiden winners. We take a look at some of the rankings for both the Oaks and the Derby. It's free to subscribe. See the description below. Just subscribe and you'll get it every Monday morning. And we'll be doing that all the way through the Belmont Stakes. So, published on Mondays, the Thoroughbred Prospectus. Hit subscribe. What did you think of Forte? What about Practical Move? Who's your Kentucky Derby favorite as we are on the first week of March is over? Forte, Practical Move, Confidence Game. Who do you like? Leave a comment as we get you ready for the Derby 2023.